命把握财富脉搏。观众朋友们大家好，欢迎您收看华尔街一周节目，我是康露，现在是在华尔街的中心美国纽约证券交易所，为您带来最新的美股资讯以及财富动向。先来看一下本周之内美股的整体走势。本周之内，美股市场最为关注的焦点就是就业数据了。周三，美国 ADP 公司公布十二月份私营板块新增就业达23.8万人，远好于市场原本的预计。特别是营建板块新增就业达4.8万人，继续显示美国楼市温和向好。随后，交易员对于周五即将公布的非农就业报告可谓是寄予厚望。但是很可惜，这份十二月的非农就业报告最终让市场是大失所望。虽然失业率降至6.7%，但是却源自于劳动参与率的降低。一方面，美国十二月份严酷的天气让很多人放弃找工作，另一方面也是因为上世纪婴儿潮当中出生的很多人都选择在近几年退休，进一步加速了美国就业市场萎缩。受到好坏参半就业数据的影响，本周之内道指收低0.2%，标普收高0.6%，而纳斯达克综合指数最后收高1%。大宗商品板块同样因为非农就业数据让人大失所望，随后黄金大涨。市场预计美联储很有可能延缓减少购债时间表，但是进入2014年之后，黄金未来是否一切向好呢？我们特地请到芝加哥商交所交易员迈克尔来谈一谈他对黄金未来走势的看法。Hi, Michael. Thank you for joining us. From a technical perspective, what is the pivot level for gold prices in the near future?
The trading range for gold to the downside might have been put in already. Now, clearly, a lot of very good astute forecasts have shown bottoms as low as 800, 880, even 900 from today's opening levels. But really, I think my range is going to be more around the 950 to 1350 range. I think we're going to stay somewhat narrow for a range for probably the first quarter.But a lot of good buying in gold would probably be a very healthy sign if we start to see a pullback and you see gold anywhere near $1,000. And when I say $1,000, I mean above the $1,000 mark, just below $1,100. I think that 300 to 400 point range is a very healthy scenario. But again, it's still a downward slope. If we do get a sharp pullback, I think it's a buying opportunity.
And entering 2014, what is the key to financial market that you will pay close attention to for this whole year?
Clearly, the biggest down risk for financial markets in 2014 is going to be not just the dependence on the markets to get off of the Fed's implementation of bond buying, but more importantly, if the markets themselves start to perceive that higher rates are not sustainable and that low rate environment has to remain all of the year. Clearly, right now, this is based off of employment, the dependence on how earnings come through,And lastly, the housing market. If we would start to see growth in the market as a whole, that would be very bullish for the US economy. But at the same time, if rates in the 10-year yield in particular would shoot up above 3.5%, and then we start seeing some type of housing demise, we're really getting a recipe for an implementation by the Fed to be extremely counterproductive. So I clearly think that would be the biggest caveat to watching an unsteady market in 2014.
好，感谢迈克尔从芝加哥为我们带来的精彩点评。下面进入一组个股新闻。本周，美国铝业公布最新财报，开启新财季。报告显示，2013年第四季度净亏损23亿美元，和每股亏损2.19美元。展望2014年，美铝表示受商用飞机需求推动，全球航空航天业铝需求增长强劲，全球增速将达7%到8%，并预计中国汽车铝需求增速将达6%到10%。科技板块中，苹果 CEO 库克下个月将和三星负责人会面，市场关注双方专利权大战能否和解。同时，苹果和全球最大电信运营商中国移动合作本月正式展开。华尔街预计第一季度苹果将从中移动获得额外300万部的 iPhone 销售盈利，苹果股价本周重回550美元以上。那么下周美股市场又有哪些新的关注热点呢？在宏观经济数据方面，美国将公布最新的新屋开建、零售销售以及消费者信心指数。而在财报方面，华尔街一系列大投行将公布最新财报，其中有包括美国银行、花旗银行、摩根大通以及富国银行。路透社预计2013年华尔街六大行的总收入会达到730亿美元，涨幅22%，有望创下次贷危机以来最好的银行盈利季节。纵览美股资讯，把握财富脉搏，欢迎回来，这里是华尔街一周节目，我是康露，现在是在华尔街的中心美国纽约证券交易所，为您带来最新的美股资讯以及财富动向。二零 2013年，美国复苏见货动力，而中国经济温和向好。时间进入2014年之后，全球经济新增长点会出现在哪里？而投资人又应该把钱投在哪个市场呢？我们特地请到了华尔街的投资大师 Jim Rogers 来谈一谈2014年投资策略的看法。
罗杰斯为美国著名投资者、经济分析师、大学教授及作家，曾与索罗斯共同创立量子基金，以投资于商品期货而闻名，有商品大王之称。
First of all, how would you evaluate the overall global economy right now?
Well, the world is floating on an artificial sea, an artificial ocean of liquidity, because every major central bank in the world is printing a lot of money, lots of money. Japanese said unlimited, America said $1 trillion a year. So with all this money floating around, and the people who are getting that moneyare better off and are happier and their friends are. So some parts are doing better, others are not doing so well.
So you do believe that the U.S. is on the recovery process, right?
Well, some parts of the U.S. are under recovery. Certainly the U.S. stock market, the big companies and the averages are doing better, but unemployment is still higher than it was 5 years ago. No, many parts of the American economy are not doing so much better.
So which industry do you think is mainly supporting the U.S. economy?
Right now, the U.S. economy, the stock market is making all-time highs, but that's a few small, a small number of big companies are the ones making the stock market go higher. So the stock market is the best part of the American economy right now.
Let's focus on China right now. What do you think is China's next growth point right now? Because we know you were in China like a few days ago, right? Mm. And I saw, I read the newspaper and I saw you were thinking about buying an apartment in Nanjing, right?
No.
No?
That's what you read?
Yeah.
No, Nanjing. And I said I've been to Nanjing a few times now. I said that I'd like to see what's happening in Nanjing. I said I want to take my family there for a visit.But no, I don't have any plans to buy a place in Nanjing. I mean, who knows? But I know, I don't certainly know. Whoever wrote that did not know what they were writing.
So generally, what do you think the Chinese real estate sector is going to be?
Well, Beijing has said they're going to slow things down. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to fight Beijing. Beijing says they're going to slow things down. I suspect they will. And as they slow things down, then maybe I would buy something. But I'm not going to buy when Beijing has said,we want to cut back. Now, if you buy something in China, one thing I've learned, you wait until you can find very good quality in the right location. And then even if things slow down, you'll probably be okay. But find the good quality and the good location. And for all I know, Nanjing might be the place. I don't have any plans. No, we go to many cities in China, and we like many parts of China.
Great. Last question, how would you forecast the world economy and the Chinese economy in the next year?
Oh, the people that could benefit from money printing, financial markets will do. I bought financial stocks in China recently. So the people who benefit from money printing and a lot of money sloshing around will do better. But some parts of the Chinese economy are going to do extremely well. The government, the new plan, they've said railroads, healthcare, agriculture, pollution control, these areas are going to do extremely well.Because the government is now going to support them. Oh, and babies. People will have more babies, so yes. Companies which do things for babies will be better too.
Great. Thank you, Mr. Rogers. Thank you. For
My pleasure. Thank you.
好，以上就是本期华尔街一周的全部内容。感谢您的收看，我们下期再会。